Good morning, happy Tuesday. So today is the first day that I'm starting my weekly vlog because I worked on Monday. But I am at my most favorite place in the entire world besides my home with my family. A lot of you guys that live in Arizona have asked me where this is. It is Spook Hill. It's in East Mesa and it's pretty darn close to my house, so I don't have to go very far to enjoy all of this. And it is an outstanding day to be outside doing a workout. I'm still actually gonna go to the gym tonight. I've climbed this mountain twice now today and I may do it one more time, but I'm still gonna go to the gym with Oscar later tonight so that way I can do weights. I just will probably skip the cardio since this is an extreme cardio workout. So always remember, you guys, you don't need a gym to work out. All you need, if you have mountains, go hiking. If you have hills, go climb hills. You don't even need a mountain or a hill. Just work out at home, find YouTube videos, go for a walk, you know, do jumping jacks, do squats, do push-ups, do anything. As long as you are moving, getting your heart rate up, maybe working up a bit of a sweat, you're good. So, got to see another lizard on my hike today, but this time it wasn't like, you know, just your typical, the way you would see a lizard. So I met, oh, I thought that was a lizard down there. So I'm, you know, minding my own business, hiking up this hill, and the next thing you know, I see this guy holding this massive lizard, and he has like four boys, I don't know, probably around the ages of maybe 6 to 10, and the dude caught a freaking Gila monster. I was like, dude, you are cray. That was pretty cool though. Glad it wasn't me that caught it, but I did get a picture, so I'll put a picture up here somewhere. And yeah, I was like, dude, you are crazier than I am, because there is no way in 18 double hockey sticks that I would have ever done that. But yeah, it was pretty cool to see. Again, glad it wasn't me though. And it was actually kind of a smaller Gila monster. But on the other hand, I was kind of worried for him too. I was like, oh dear Heavenly Father, please don't let that thing bite him or any of his children, because I was like, that would suck. Because those of you guys who don't know, Gila monsters are extremely poisonous. He really didn't look afraid at all though, so I'm like, well, more power to you, dude. We only get one life, so live it up the way you want to live it up is my philosophy. But, you know, just be thankful every day that you wake up and you get to spend another glorious day on this earth, because look how gorgeous this earth is. That mountain right there. In the winter time, sometimes we get snow on there and it is gorgeous. One of these days over the winter, if we get snow on the mountain, then I will climb this and I will do a video up here, but it's really pretty when we get snow on there.
Gonna have us a taco bowl. Oh yeah.
All right, so I'm just using this parchment paper as well as some of this cheese. You can use whatever cheese you want, but that's the cheese that I have on hand. But I just put about a handful of that cheese on the parchment paper and I'm gonna microwave it to where it's wanting to kind of start to crisp up, but it's not super crisp to where you can't form it. Then I just put the entire thing with the parchment paper in the bowl, just like that, and then I let it cool off, and as it cools, it'll harden up. All right, it is done. So we have our taco meat, some romaine lettuce, some salsa, some sour cream, and of course our cheese taco bowl. This is going to be freaking bomb! If you have not tried making taco shells or taco bowls out of cheese, you need to go do that right now. And I'm going to drink this Georgia peach sweet tea bang with my lunch, because after that hike, I am gonna need some energy to get me through the rest of the day. I have not tried this one yet, so I'll try it and I'll give you guys my thoughts on it. If you have tried it and you like it, let me know in the comments below. All right, so I'm gonna enjoy dessert before I even eat dinner, because next week is carnivore week and I'm gonna live it up before I start that. And I'm also drinking one of the pecan pie coffees that I got at Walmart, because Walmart's bringing out their holiday flavors, and I'm doing it in a Christmas cup. No judging. All right, so for dinner, I'm just gonna do this meatloaf that I prepared in my meal prep video. So if you haven't seen that, go check it out. And look at the green chilies poking through there. Yummy. So this is all I'm gonna have. I'm really not that hungry and I just wanna put a little something something in my belly before I go to the gym. So let's enjoy this and head off to the gym.
When you feel the world is over. When you say you're feeling lonely, if you ever need a shoulder, you know where to find me. Stop chasing.
Explain my muscles in one word, it would be jello, because we got one heck of an amazing workout. It was leg day and we also did chest. Again, got out of my comfort zone, went into where all the guys work out, and there's women too, but it's mostly guys. And half of those machines, like, I don't know, I'd have to watch somebody to even know how to use them. But you know what, it's kind of nice because you get in there, it's kind of intimidating. But you go and you figure these machines out, and then once you figure them out, you feel like you have accomplished something. So, and it's nice, like I said last week, to just get out of the comfort zone, get into a little bit of a different routine, because the more you change it up, hopefully we'll see more results. So next week is the carnivore challenge, and I'm also on vacation, not really vacation, it's more like a staycation. And it's going to be perfect because I could probably go to the gym a little bit more, but it is going to be nice and I'm going to get in there and kill it. Today we killed it. Holy cow. Again, jello, y'all. Jello. Also, I know I've said this before, but don't be intimidated by going to the gym. Every single person in there is doing it to get healthy. They're doing it to either lose weight, get healthy, be a better you. Be a better them, whatever they're trying to be. But everybody's in there for the same reasons. We're all trying to do our best, be healthy, look better, lose weight, and nobody is gonna judge you. If you have been contemplating getting a gym membership and you're on the fence because you feel intimidated, or if you're on the fence because you feel like people are gonna judge you, don't feel that way. Get in there. Everybody's in it to win it, and everybody's in there for the same reasons.
Deja vu from last week. We went to Fry's after we worked out just to pick up a couple of things because today's last day for the sale for Fry's for this week. So we picked up the Maxwell House coffee, and they did have their K-Cups on sale for $4.99. And when you buy five. So I got toffee nut, caramel, and then Oscar wanted the Italian roast, the dark roast. Picked up some lemons, avocados. It was cheaper to buy the avocados like this. I think they were $3.99. And then, y'all, I think I'm cray because I did pick up some of this Yancy Fancy Ghost Pepper natural aged cheddar cheese, and I have a feeling this is going to be hot, but it was regularly $6.99 and it was on closeout for only like $4.99, so I figured this was the perfect time to pick that up and try that. But that is our little haul after we left the gym. I am snacky today, and I don't know why. So, I'm having a little bit of this dill cheese, as well as some of these Blue Diamond salt and vinegar almonds, and those are like life, those and the wasabi. Freaking amazing. And then I just tried this for the first time, and this is freaking amazing. That is what it looks like. And I love dill flavored almost anything, so I'm gonna have this little snack and then I'll probably just do dinner tonight, but this is gonna be bomb, y'all. The cheese that I picked up last night, holy freaking ghost pepper, what the heck. Like, I can handle a lot of things, hot. This burnt my mouth literally as soon as it touched it. So, unless you're very brave, I don't know about that. Like, I'm gonna have to find somebody else that is way braver than I to take this cheese and eat it, because I'm no wimp, but woo-wee, when they say ghost pepper, like, they are not joking.
Help a girl out, my friend. Help a girl out.
Hey, y'all. Happy Wednesday. So, as you saw, I had my coffee. Those of you guys who don't know, I just put heavy whipping cream, and I've been using those Jordan Skinny syrups. So, I got the salted caramel, and then I got the butter toffee one, and those are freaking delicious. So I've been putting the butter toffee one in my I don't know if you watch my grocery haul, but Walmart has a great value pecan pie coffee. It's their seasonal coffee that they're bringing out, and I've been putting the butter toffee one in that coffee, and then I got the caramel coffee from Walmart as well, and then I also had some Starbucks ones. And I've been putting the caramel, the salted caramel in there, and it is oh so freaking good, y'all. So I have really been enjoying those Jordan Skinny syrups. Those are freaking delicioso. And I highly recommend both of those. And I think the only other kind TJ Maxx had at that time was vanilla. And I think that's it, but I don't remember. Anyway, I'm gonna keep my eye out and see if I can find other flavors there. But I told you guys, I'm kind of snacky today, and I don't know what it is. So I had that blueberry bar, and I actually had that early this morning with my coffee, which I usually don't even eat in the mornings. Most of the time, I don't even eat until like noon, 1 o'clock. So whatever, it is what it is. And then I had that snack. I had that cheese with the almonds, and not even gonna lie, I went for a second serving of those almonds. Bad, I know. And then I am actually going to probably make steak for dinner and chicken, and I'm just gonna make like a bulk amount so that way I have it for the next 2 days, because I work Thursday and Friday. So anyway, I have been super snacky, and the only thing I can think of is it's probably supposed to be that time of the month. I never really know when it's that time of the month because I had a uterine ablation, so I don't have periods anymore. Probably TMI, sorry about that. But it is what it is. But I still get the symptoms. So I still kind of get the bloating. I still get the kind of bleh kind of feeling. I still get the cravings. I still get all of that. But I never like really know because, like I said, I don't have anything. Let me just touch on one subject real quick, because I had somebody get into touch with me on Instagram, and they DM'd me and asked me, because I guess they watched one of my prior videos, your fat intake and all that good stuff, where if you still have weight to lose and if you take in too much fat, you may not lose weight. And she kind of didn't understand that. She was like, well, what does that mean? Because I mean, it's keto. It's high fat, moderate protein, low carb, which it is. It is considered, I mean, keto is considered a high fat, moderate protein, low carb diet. However, if you're trying to lose weight and if you have plenty of fat on your body, you have lots of fat stores for your body to go to. So you can cut down on that fat a little bit to lose the weight a little bit quicker. Because, I mean, if you take in too much fat, your body's gonna store it. Keto is a metabolic state within your body that, you know, just because you do keto doesn't necessarily mean you're going to lose weight. You still have to be careful with, and I know a lot of people will disagree with me on this, but it's still calories in, calories out do matter. You can't go and eat extreme amounts of fat and still expect to lose weight, because your body will store that fat, and you know, you want to burn the fat off of your tummy first. And I think that's why my weight loss myself is so slow, because you know, you guys have seen what I eat. I eat a lot of casseroles, and I eat a lot of stuff that has cream cheese and cheese and, you know, all this stuff that has a ton of fat. And if I would cut back on my fat, I would probably lose weight quicker. I'm not saying don't eat fat, and I'm not saying be afraid of fat. I'm just saying that you can't eat excessive amounts and expect to lose the weight that you're wanting to lose, especially the closer that you get to your goal weight. You know, because I'm getting closer
closer and closer to my goal weight, and the less you have to lose, the harder it is. It was so much easier for me to lose weight when I was 204 pounds rather than now. So I'm just throwing that out there. Don't be afraid of fat, but definitely be cautious of how much you're putting into your body if you are still trying to lose the weight. All right, so hopefully that wasn't confusing. I guess what I'm just trying to say is when you put all your numbers, let's just say you're tracking, when you put all your numbers into Carb Manager and Carb Manager gives you that certain percent for fat, and obviously you need to put your numbers in at a deficit. I usually put mine in my deficit when I did track around 15 to 20%. They say that over 20% deficit is a little bit too much. You probably shouldn't go over 20% deficit is what I've always heard. But again, just remember the fats are a limit. Don't ever go over the fats, because like I said, when you have that much fat to burn on your belly, you want your body to be able to get into your fat reserves to eat up that fat on your tummy and not the fat that you're putting into your mouth. So I hope that makes sense for all of you guys. And if you're tracking and you're eating the amount of fat that the Carb Manager has allowed you and you're still losing weight, go for it, y'all. But if you are eating that amount of fat and you're not losing weight, you may want to tame it down just a little bit. And it's almost like an experiment. Everybody has everybody has a different body. Everybody has a different way they lose weight, and every body is different. You know, there's different metabolisms. Everybody's weight loss is going to be different. Everybody's story is different. So I feel like every single person has to kind of experiment for themselves to see where they need to keep their fats or where they need to keep their proteins. It's almost like everybody needs to find that sweet spot for themselves. So I hope that makes sense. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below down here or DM me on Instagram. I am more than happy to help you. And if I don't know the answer, I will try to find it for you. But again, I hope that that was helpful, and I will see you at the gym tonight.
When you feel the world is over, when you say you're feeling lonely, if you ever need a shoulder, you know where to find me. Stop chasing.
We made it. It was another rough bike workout, but we made it.
I would have been so embarrassed for my shirt to be all sweaty like that up in that gym. But you know what? Nowadays, I don't care. I own that sweat. You guys need to own that sweat. Be proud of that sweat. And you know what? I don't even care. It was like a wet t-shirt contest up in You Fit. Be proud of your sweat and don't ever be ashamed, because guess what? You worked hard for that.
All right, so for dinner, I am just gonna live it up carnivore style and have this steak. And then I will probably just do a collagen shake with that. And I'll show you what I put in the collagen shake, but I am gonna enjoy this for now. I guess I'm just preparing for next week's carnivore week, which I am so stoked about. Yes. Preferred Elements Keto Collagen. This is always linked in the description box below if you guys want to give it a try.
I'm going to have some of this unsweetened cashew milk and then avocado. I just throw all of that in my blender and blend it up, and it is absolutely delicious. The avocado makes it super creamy, and it almost tastes like a dessert, pretty much. That's pretty much how I treat this. It's freaking amazing. So good. I never ever thought that I would intake this many avocados in a week, but this is the only way I can do it.
Hey y'all, happy Saturday. So I am officially on vacation. It is the kids' October break, and I pretty much take off every single October break with them just because, you know, they're getting older and pretty soon we're not gonna have that with them. So, you know, cause my son is a senior and my daughter is a sophomore. So for me, it's super important to take off as much time as I possibly can with them because, you know, eventually I'm not gonna have that, you guys, and that is such a sad thought to even think about. So I was actually chit-chatting with Nicole on Instagram, and she went camping over the weekend, and so I was like, enjoy yourself, you know, have a great time, relax. And she was like, girl, I cannot relax because I got kids. And I remember those days, trust me, I remember those days, but I was like, just enjoy it. It goes by so fast. Just enjoy them being little, because it doesn't last forever, and I am going to miss that. But I'm here at the store. We are actually going to do my father-in-law's 70th birthday party this weekend, since last weekend we were not able to, because if you guys watched my last vlog, he got sick and my brother-in-law got sick. But this weekend, we are actually adding in, so we're gonna be doing my father-in-law's 70th birthday party. It's gonna be Oscar's birthday here soon, and it was my niece's birthday. So we are just going to do a birthday party for all three of them. Also, can I talk about the workouts that I did during the week? OMG, I was sore. Today's the first day that I'm actually not really sore, but Thursday and Friday I worked. I was so sore. I have an office job. I do have a desk that you can raise up and you can stand, so that was perfect because I was like, I would die if I had to just sit here the entire time. Holy cow. Because even the little times that I sat, when I would get up, I was so stiff because I was so sore. My arms were sore, my legs were sore. But again, it's been perfect getting out of that comfort zone, so I am loving it. I kind of put myself together, but people are starting to show up, so I'm gonna get out there. But I just wanted to let you guys know that some of you guys asked how I prepared to do the carnivore diet. Well, I'm not really preparing too much. My goal was to kind of this morning have my coffee with my Jordan skinny syrup, and then hopefully nothing after that. But you know what? I made some pumpkin cake pops, but I figure, you know what? It's my father-in-law's 70th birthday. It's Oscar's birthday. It's my niece's birthday, and I am going to enjoy one of those pumpkin cake pops. So my plan is to enjoy myself today, especially since it's like birthday fun right now. Obviously, I'm gonna stay keto, and I had a salad for lunch. I'll probably enjoy one of those cake pops for dessert. And then I didn't make anything keto as far as what we're making meal-wise. Everybody kind of brought a dish, so nothing out there really is keto except for the protein, you know, the steaks and the chicken and stuff. So I'm probably going to be carnivore tonight. But then tomorrow, I'm gonna stay completely away from the sweets. I'm gonna eat kind of whatever I want keto, but I'm gonna stay away from the sweets. So hopefully maybe that will help me out. We'll see. Happy Sunday.
All right, that's all they have left. Last time I was here, this entire counter was full of Jordan Skinny Syrup.
Has anybody tried this one? Jordan Skinny Syrup Glazed Donut. $3.99. I don't know if that sounds good or not. Leave a comment down below if you've tried it. Let me know if it's good.
These ones are my favorites. These smell so good.
All right, dinner's about to go down. I'm gonna have a burger with mayonnaise, a little bit of sugar-free ketchup, and some pico de gallo, along with the sausage. It's about to go down, y'all.
All right, y'all, I just wanted to jump on here and end this video. Cray cray day, meal prepped, had company over, but it is super late. I'm actually in my pajamas now and about ready to go to bed, but I wanted to end this video first. But I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit more about the carnivore challenge. By the time you actually see this, you probably already started the carnivore challenge. Or maybe you're starting it later, whatever. It doesn't even matter. I mean, you're doing this challenge for you. I have had a lot of people reach out to me on Instagram asking me several questions about what they can have, what they cannot have. And the biggest thing is make sure that you're only eating things that come from animals. So, like for instance, I went to the grocery store, I stocked up on beef, I got ribeye steak from the meat market, I got hamburgers, chicken, salmon. Technically, you can eat all of that. Strict carnivores, they actually only eat red meats, eggs, and I think bacon. Like, they're crazy strict. I'm gonna allow myself chicken and salmon and all that good stuff as well. I'm just probably gonna try to do more red meat than the salmon and the chicken. And then you can have dairy, just try to limit the dairy. Just like, I'll probably still put heavy whipping cream in my coffee. And then that's another thing too, is technically coffee is not carnivore because coffee comes from a plant. But yeah, nobody wants to see me without coffee. So I'm gonna incorporate coffee, and I am gonna put just a little bit of heavy whipping cream in there. And then, I mean, if I want a little bit of cheese here and there, I'm gonna have a little bit of cheese here and there. And if you're not aware, Monterey Jack has zero carbs. So just throwing that out there, so that way if you want some cheese that doesn't really have carbs. But yeah, just try to keep it basic, you know, just try to keep it simple. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm not making this carnivore thing difficult. I'm just making it simple because I personally am still learning about the carnivore diet myself. And I mean, like I said, in my grocery haul, I don't even really know how fancy you could even possibly go with carnivore. I'm guessing like not too fancy, but you know, I'm just keeping it simple. I'm just making simple things. I'll eat a burger, you know, and maybe I'll have a chaffle with my burger, have my ribeye, cook my ribeye in butter, you know, just super duper simple, you guys. Another thing too, I just wanted to say thank you to every single one of you guys, because I've had a ton of people just literally within like the last few weeks reaching out to me, telling me you guys' success stories, how much you've lost and how much amount of time. And I've had people send me your carb manager spread and just saying, hey, you know what? Look at me. You know, I did an awesome job today. I stayed on track. And I just want to say congratulations to every single one of you guys, because every single one of these stories just blows my freaking mind. I mean, it's just mind blowing. And I'm so happy for every single one of you guys. And every single one of you guys, I just keep going. Never give up. You are worth it. And you are doing freaking amazing. Just never forget how good it feels. Have it all that weight off and never give up, you guys. You guys are just all freaking rock stars. And I just want to give each and every one of you a hug if I could. But you guys are all doing amazing. Keep sending me those stories, because I love hearing that. I love hearing each and every single one of your stories. I love seeing, you know, you guys excited. I love you guys sending me your spreadsheets of what you're eating. So just remember, we are all in this together, and every single one of you guys, like I said, are just rock freaking stars. And don't ever give up, you guys. And I just want to touch on one more thing, because I had another person actually reach out to me today asking me, you know, what I thought of what their carb manager looked like. And just remember, this is something that I can't stress highly enough. It's kind of the same thing that I touched on Wednesday when I was talking about fats and stuff like that. Just a real quick example. When you put all your information into Carb Manager and Carb Manager gives you all of your numbers, you know, like this many calories, this much fat, this much protein, this much carbs. Just remember, calories, you really want to reach your calorie goal. You don't want to eat too little calories because your body needs all that nutrition. You know, if it says that you're supposed to be eating 1300, 1400 calories, eat your 1300, 1400 calories. Don't go 1,000 calories because you think you're going to lose more weight. And the same thing with protein. If protein says that you need 85 grams of protein, hit that protein goal because protein is essential. You could have a lot of side effects if you're not hitting your protein goal. You know, I've heard of a lot of people even losing their hair if they're not eating enough protein. So make sure you hit that protein goal. Fats is a limit. So let's say that it says you can have 120 grams of fat. If you want to eat all the way up to your 120 grams of fat, by all means, eat it, but don't go over, especially if you're trying to lose weight. And that's another thing with carbs, too. If it says you can only have 20 grams of net carbs, only eat your 20 grams of net carbs. Don't go over, because that's pretty essential for losing weight as well. And even then, some people have to figure out their own body type, and they have to figure out that sweet spot. So you may have to adjust your fats a little bit down as well as your carbs a little bit down to possibly even lose weight. It just depends on the person. Not everybody loses the same way. So I did want to touch on that again because I feel like I get a lot of questions about that. Other than that, I think that's all I have for you guys this week. If you like this video, if you could smash that like button, I would greatly appreciate it. As well as, I would love to have you as part of my Simply Misty family, so please consider subscribing. And if you subscribe, don't forget to tap that bell so you can get notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate every single one of you guys. And don't forget to go out there and make today even better than yesterday. And I will talk to you in my next video. Bye. On my own, but I don't know why. You hit the road, but you don't realize. I won't look back when you're around. I won't think twice when